Hi, today I show you this other kind of excavator which I have here available today, because I made already other videos about Komatsu excavators, and this one is unknown yet to me. No, IHI is written on it. Let's have a look. Now I will have, before the machine will start to work, I will look at the instruments, all the handles. So this is looking like a kind of gear handle to me. Sorry, this is for active, for moving the tools in front. And here we have temperature, fuel level, and battery charge. Oil pressure, very important, probably hydraulic. Here is quick glow. I don't know, that's usually on diesel engines. And there's a battery level and two pluses, no idea for what. This is the number of hours the machine is running. Means each time you switch on the engine, it will count the number of hours and minutes with that clock, because people are invoiced accordingly. When the people pay, rent these machines, they will have a look at this clock. Now here are different labels. I will show them one after the other. Ah. Okay, you put it in a mix. That's on the side, below the fuel tank. Oh no, not the fuel tank, is it? No, something. Here we have another Japanese writing on the back. And here's something interesting, a green cross with hand-painted calligraphic, beautiful Japanese letters. It's really handwork. Somebody was painting this with a paintbrush. Nice. And there's the exhaust. Let's have a look at the engine. And here's the fuel tank. So there we put inside diesel. It's so kind to open that hood to check the engine. Ah, so there's antifreeze, something we will never need in Sri Lanka. There's the oil filter here. There is this is the same the tuk-tuk, no?
Silencer.
Huh?
Silencer.
Yeah, but this tuk-tuk silencer. They installed a silencer of a three-wheeler. Seems to be really enough. And here's the air filter. And here you put in more coolant for the engine. And here's the Isuzu diesel motor. Cylinder gear, three cylinder. We can see that here are the injectors. So it has an injection pump somewhere. And what, this is the fuel tank, right? Yeah, fuel. Here we have the fuel. And what is this here? What color is this? What is this? Stand?
Gun stand.
Gun?
Grease gun stand.
Ah, grease gun. You can put the grease gun. I was already thinking other guns. So, and down there you have the diesel filter. So, only that part which is below there is going off. That one on top stays when they switch. And here we have these silent blocks which are making that the engine is not directly connected to the frame and vibrating. And then we have a little fence in front of the fan, which is very nice, so that when people even work here during the maintenance and the engine is running, they will be protected, or anything else should not fall inside, being sucked maybe or whatever. And here is, what is this? This is a hydraulic fluid filter. And this is the place where you put the hydraulic fuel. Yeah. So because now we are done with the engine, thank you. And here are all these hydraulic fuel conducts, which are made rubberized, but inside is a very strong metal mesh, so that these things can resist to very high pressure. I mean, when you know what this machine is able to lift, how much power it has, it can lift off rocks of more than a ton, and even tree trunks and all this, and it's all this power is just going through these little this like the veins of the body of that machine. And here we have some grease which has been put abundantly to make sure that the metal is not getting too much tear and wear. And here we see that cylinder. That's the cylinder and this part which is going in and out when the machine is activated by the conductor. And you see everything is heavy duty, although the machine looks so small when you are considering that it has, it's like a very small car only, and it can do so much more than a normal person would expect from such a small machine. Okay, now we will see it in operation. Something noteworthy, the driver operator is having this steel construction above his head and in his back. This is to avoid that when the machine rolls over, that the driver will be smashed under the machine. It gives him higher chances to survive. And the little plastic, which is still more large, is just for the sun and the rain. So the protection is done by this large, very heavy duty steel bar mount and the small extension left and right. Wait, so the operator will now start the engine. Here we go. I'll back up a little bit to get the whole machine. Ah, okay, so now he's starting to work. Right now, to rent this machine is 1,500 rupees per hour. Hour, which means according to the clock, which means when the engine is running, not when the machine is standing here or the driver is having a tea or a phone call, then he shuts down the engine, so that doesn't even count. So, 1,500 rupees for this very big help. That is less than $1. Am I right? Wait. No. It's like $8 maybe, or $7 per hour. In Sri Lanka, some people having machines like that will rent them out for a little bit more money, but it's always more or less in the maximum $10 per hour range. Now this little bucket of just 200 kilograms, that's nothing. Let's see, the next thing is the concrete mixer to be moved. Now that thing is just a cut barrel. Inside we have our red brick powder which we use for tainting the mortar. Wait, parakina. Okay, now it's okay. Now let's go for the real job. So we will move this concrete mixer with this IHI excavator. Temporarily we need to make a foundation there, so that's just that we need to move it immediately to another place, and it's very heavy. You can see the machine is stuck in the ground with the wheels because a lot of cement has been pouring out during the many months of work. You can see the wheels, but this excavator has enough power to rip this machine out of the ground. Must do it slowly because we don't want to break anything. And the wheels have been covered with rice bags before. It was a good idea because now the wheel spokes are not just glued in the concrete. That big rope is from a ship. It's from a ship. It is a recycled rope from a big ship. The machine is still stuck. That's why he's not lifting it in one go. No problem. Rice bag, Kerala. So the rice bag is just the problem now that we want to get rid of that rice bag. Seems that the rice bag has quite a power, so we need to cut it. Now you can notice how easy that machine is holding this concrete mixer above the ground for minutes already. The concrete mixer is not the heaviest thing such a machine can lift up, of course. I'll maybe make another video when this machine will lift up an entire heavy tree trunk, which we also need to move. So let me tell you that this machine is now only temporarily deposited there. It's not even going to stand level. It's just out of the way so that we can dig a foundation. And this video about this machine is now going to be finished. I think you also noticed that these machines are very, very useful. I'd like to own one, but not enough money to do that right now. They are not that expensive. You can get these machines for what was the price I was told? $5,000-$6,000 you can get such a second-hand machine in Sri Lanka. Here's our job done. The machine is standing in another place and this man can now work foundations. Now we are scooping away some rocks, which handwork combined with the machine is very useful because we don't need to lift them that much. We need to get rid of these stones in this area real quick. Thank you.